Hi guys, Cliff Olson, Doctor of Audiology and founder of Applied Hearing Solutions in Phoenix, Arizona. And in this video, in honor of World Hearing Day, March 3rd, I'm talking about the three things that you need to know when it comes to your hearing. Coming up. Every year on March 3rd is considered World Hearing Day. This day is intended to raise awareness about hearing loss prevention and to promote hearing care across the world. Not only is hearing one of your five senses, but it is arguably the most important sense when it comes to communication with others. As an audiologist, I am constantly reminded on a daily basis of three extremely important things when it comes to your hearing. But before I share what these three things are, if you could do me a huge favor and click the like button, it really helps out my channel because it gets these videos in front of a broader audience. And while you're at it, if you have not yet hit that subscribe button with notification bell, go ahead and do that as well because that ensures that you never miss one of my newly released videos, and I release multiple videos every single week. That being said, I really appreciate it. Now let's talk about that first most important thing, which is protecting your hearing. Maintaining your ability to hear requires the preservation of tiny microscopic hair cells inside of your ears that allow sounds to make it to your brain. Most humans have approximately 15,000 hair cells in each ear at birth. 12,000 of these hair cells are called outer hair cells that are responsible for making sounds audible enough for you to hear. And approximately 3,000 of these hair cells are considered inner hair cells that are responsible for taking these audible sounds and transferring them cleanly up to your brain so you can understand them. Most people have no idea how delicate these hair cells are and how easy it is to damage them, resulting in a hearing loss. While there are a number of things that can damage these hair cells, like genetics, age, chemical exposure, and head trauma, the number one most preventable form of damage is noise exposure. I remember being a teenager and listening to music way too loud, which is likely the reason that I have a hearing loss in my right ear. In fact, it wasn't until I was in Marine Corps boot camp where the military audiologist told me that I needed to be protecting my hearing anytime I was around loud noise. While it was too late for me to save my right ear from noise-induced hearing loss, it was that interaction with the military audiologist that prevented me from losing even more hearing when I served as a Marine Corps Scout Sniper, because anytime I was in a noisy situation, I wore hearing protection. Now, in case you don't know, there are three basic forms of hearing protection. The first one is to just avoid noisy situations. The second one is to use in-the-ear hearing protection. And the third one is to use over-the-ear hearing protection. Avoidance is simple. Just don't put yourself into a noisy situation. But if you're not sure what a noisy situation is and if it is going to be enough noise to cause damage to your hearing, one great thing that you can use is an Apple iWatch. I have an Apple iWatch right here, and it will actually track the amount of noise in your situation. So if you end up exceeding a certain level of noise, it will give you a warning saying that you can only be in that situation for a certain period of time. Now, there are a variety of different in-the-ear hearing protectors, but my personal favorite is just to use these little foam protectors. You essentially roll them like this between your fingers to make them really skinny, and then you pull your ear back and insert it into your ear canal about 3/4 of the way, and you hold it there until that hearing protector expands. Once it expands, it is one of the best forms of hearing protection that you can actually use. Now, for whatever reason, if you can't get in the ear hearing protection, or you just can't figure out how to get it inside of your actual ear, you can always go for the over-the-ear earmuffs. These earmuffs are great. You just have to make sure that they're in good condition and that the pads are not cracking, so it actually prevents that noise from damaging your hearing. The point is, you need to protect those hair cells, and if you do, it significantly increases the chance that you'll have good hearing for a really long time. The second most important thing when it comes to your hearing is identification of hearing loss. If for whatever reason you do develop a hearing loss, it is very important to identify that earlier rather than later. This is why ReSound, today's video sponsor, has developed an online hearing test to help you easily identify whether you may have a hearing loss. All you have to do is go to ReSound.com or click the link that I will have down in the description. After entering some basic demographic information, you will complete a series of tests where you will first identify certain words with varying degrees of speech babble as background noise, Then you will identify different numbers among static background noise. The test only takes a few minutes, and ReSound will indicate if you have a possible hearing loss. If it does identify a hearing loss, the next best thing that you can do is go in and see a hearing care professional for a comprehensive hearing evaluation to determine how severe your hearing loss is and if your hearing loss would require treatment. And treatment of your hearing loss happens to be the third most important thing when it comes to your hearing. If you were unsuccessful in protecting your hearing from noise exposure, or you have hearing loss due to things you can't control like genetics or age, and you're fortunate enough to have identified your hearing loss, then treatment is the next best thing that you can do. In order to do this successfully, you need to find the right hearing aid technology and a hearing care professional who can get the most out of that technology. ReSound has been manufacturing hearing aids since 1943 and is one of the most recognized hearing aid brands around the world. Their new ReSound 1 hearing aids are some of the most advanced hearing aids known to man, and they are the first hearing aids to ever incorporate a microphone on the back of a receiver inside of your ear canal. Not only does this m&rie receiver preserve the natural pinna effects that are unique to every individual hearing aid user, but it also fits in with ReSound's organic hearing philosophy to help you hear the way that nature intended. I say it all the time, this is the best time in history to treat your hearing loss because of all of the advancement in hearing aid technology and the advancement of fitting techniques to get the most out of your devices. Overall, World Hearing Day is that one day a year that we can sit back and reflect on just how important our hearing is. So do yourself a favor. In honor of World Hearing Day, take a few minutes to think about the ways that you can protect your hearing. If you suspect that you have a hearing loss, go ahead and get your hearing tested. And if you do have a hearing loss, get your hearing loss treated as soon as you possibly can. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. If you like the video, please share it. And if you want to see other videos just like this one, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Also, feel free to check out my website, drcliffaud.com.